you do not want to be eaten, Jill. Hello, world. My name is Chromaray, and welcome back to Resident Evil 3. Previously...
Morning, you saved my life.
I sure as shit didn't. That was all Carlos. He carried you here and he treated you himself, crazy bastard.
Where is he?
I went underground. Barge stockpiled the vaccine enough to give this city some hope.
He thinks he can do this by himself. I'm going after him.
Wait, did you see the broadcast? They're gonna blow the city sky high. I'm trying to get a hold of someone, anyone with the clearance to stop it.
Carlos is worth more than a city to him, Jill.
So am I.
Right. Guess I'm not talking you out of this.
Nope.
Storage facilities underground, beneath this hospital. I've lost contact with Carlos. So expect trouble.
You've lost contact. Why does everyone lose contact with these walkie-talkies? You'd think they would get better walkie-talkies by now. Cool, we have a grenade launcher. We have a whole bunch of nice and unique weapons. And the whole place seems to be already unlocked. I don't know where Carlos could have gone, though, that we haven't already explored. We, on the other hand, have a whole bunch of locks we can pick. I have a feeling this is the underground. I don't know how Carlos got down here, but we're gonna explore all of the bonus things first. Like this. It's probably just a grenade or something, but a grenade will come in handy if we need to fight one of those lizards. What is that? Magnum? There's a Magnum in this game? Yay! I'm sorry, Magnums, I can't hold it right now, but they're like really big pistol guns. They're like always the best gun in Resident Evil games. The ammo for them is always super rare though, so that might not be the best weapon to use at all times. Okay, hey, guess what? You want a taste of something that Carlos didn't have? Well, it says, oh my god, it didn't kill him. At least he didn't do his one shot, one kill strike. He's running away like a person who's on fire. Except he's a creature on fire. Where did you go? Stop. No, you're dead. You took a grenade blast to the face. You shouldn't have survived that. Then you're not going to survive what comes next. I wonder if there's a special item in any of these. Oh, explosive rounds are special enough. But I mean like a pouch or a weapon, a magnum. That could be hiding in one of those. There wasn't much there. We didn't pick up the magnum ammo, so if we ever find a magnum, this place is creepy. I feel like we're gonna find a regenerator here. If you don't know what a regenerator is, it's a big, bad, slimy heck of a man or a woman who's been turned into a zombo. And they have like a bajillion hearts. Like one on each of their arms and ligaments. This must be the way underground. I'm pretty sure we're underground right now. Oh, is this an elevator to go super far underground? Isn't this a hospital? This hospital had to have, something bad had to have happened here before all of this happened, because I can't think that all this umbrella stuff went to going on unnoticed.
How is it no one in the hospital ever noticed all this?
She literally proves what I'm saying. She agrees. There's a truck right there with its lights on for whatever reason. That doesn't make sense. Is there someone in here? Or was there someone in there before they got mutilated while the power to the vehicle was on and they forgot to turn off the lights? Or did they just want the lights on so that they could see this area brighter? See, that one has its lights on too. It's like they suddenly stopped all of their doing. RDPD hit pouch. Of course, what's that? That looks like a good openable box, but it's not. I don't care, we got a hit pouch, that's good enough. What does this say? Elevator notice. To all employees, we've identified an issue with the electrical box. You all need ID cards on you at all times. No. Where concurrent use of heavy Machinery overloads it and causes the fuses to blow. If you encounter this problem and can't get the elevator running again, please stay calm and gather fuses from the sub-generators situated around the warehouse, and use those to restore power from the main generator as quickly as possible. Huh. So I'm assuming this is an elevator that doesn't work. Yes, I think. This seems like it's locked. It doesn't seem like it's out of commission. But we need to find a generator or whatever they are talking. Oh, bloody bodies. Who is that? He's alive. That's... I... Frick you. He's gonna... Is he gonna say anything? Or are we just gonna look at him awkwardly? Explosive A. Can I blow up the glass? Of course I can't. That glass is like super bulletproof. I'm assuming it would, since this is a zombie chamber almost, where they would have to keep the glass from breaking so that zombies wouldn't outbreak. But of course they outbreak anyway. Apparently we're going down here where he can see us easily and shoot at us if he wants to. Well, assuming he has a weapon that can break the glass. Or robotics. Did he not see us or notice us? Or does he think we're so below him that he doesn't even need to react? Are you gonna... No, you're not. Let's go up to him, actually. This should be right next to him. Oh, of course not.
I must admit, I respect your tenacity. But I'm
you
afraid
do?
Our games end here.
You think this is over?
Are we supposed to go back upstairs? No, we can't because it's blocked. Oh, this elevator might still be working, even though the power is out. What are you? Stop. You are not regenerating on my watch. Stop. Who is this, your friend? He looks just like you. This is what you look on the inside, I bet. It's still broken. No, it's still working. I guess just the power to that one is the only one that's broken. If he can do that just by hacking or standing still looking at me with his telepathic mind, telepathic, why didn't he do it to this one? Unless he wants us to win. He's trying to find a true combatant. But he's trying to have fun with us. Ooh, more boxes to open. It's always a surprise. There could be a snake in here for all we know. Could be slithering around. Oh, geez, we can gather a lot of these. I'm still waiting for the chance that I need to use a lot of them. Because usually I've wasted probably 80% of the ones that we've gotten. Oh, we got one of the fuses. That said a 3 on it? Oh, 3 more. We just happened to get the third one of 3. So there, I'm assuming the second two are just as scattered around like that one was, where other power supply boxes are. And I'm also guessing that we're gonna stumble upon more regenerators. That's what I'm calling them. Oof! Get out of the shotgun. You stupid dog. Stupid bad dog. Bad dog. Stop. That was frightening. It's because it took control of the camera. Focused it on that while I saw the dog here, well, I heard the dog coming from my peripheral and I couldn't do anything about it. Is it gonna happen again? No? Of course not. You better not. That looks like a perfect staircase up to him. We could easily take that up. I don't know where it would lead us, but I'm sure it would be somewhere handy. Either up or sideways. Let's go sideways. I don't want to waste my last bullet, so we have to use this. The weaker gun, in case a boss fight happens.
No, wait.
This isn't a dead end, Jill. That looks like I'll die if I get mushed in there. That'd be cool if they had endings like that, where the zombies could throw you into, like, machinery. Or you could throw zombies into machinery. That's the better version of what I just said. We can combine this with something, I think. Never mind, we can't. Oh, this is the way we... What's that noise? I heard that clicking. Is it a clicker from The Last of Us? Oh, that's where the noise came from. Get away from it. It's not there anymore. Maybe it climbed up here somewhere. Because they have really long arms and they look freaking monstrous. So I'm assuming they could probably jump around really quick after they stop moving super slowly. There's another one. No, it's hiding in the back because it wants us to kill the fodder first so that it can kill us in one shot. Since it's super slow like this. See? It doesn't even seem like a... It just healed. It heals itself. Okay, either it one-shots you and that's what's really bad about it, or it regenerates like super quickly. Admitted to, into, male, 45, female, whatever, admitted to, okay, I guess these are the regenerator zombies that are here, they're just talking about them right here. Nightly transferred, observed by nurse, admissions to underground facility, temporarily halted. Oh, a nurse found out about them, so they had to silence the nurse. Or as in they had to turn her into one of these regenerators. Okay, that elevator, if that's an elevator, doesn't seem to be working either. This just leads back down? How come I didn't see this before? Oh, it leads to another section. What's in this section that makes it so special? Oh, that's what's in this section that makes it so special. Jill, I know you're badass, but being badass doesn't mean you can take out a rock zombie with a knife. I'm sure it wouldn't do anything. Come on, where are you? Jill, are you just going back to the zombie or are you gonna shoot it from up above? Where did it go? What? How can a monster that big? Oh, it's hiding in the shadows. It's pretty quiet for its size. Well, until it takes damage. If it wants to be loud, it's loud. Cool, a 2 of 3. Can we combine them or do we have to actually... Yeah, we do. Discard this so that we can take this. It's for the greater good. As much as I want my ammunition, my gunpowder, my medical herbs, sometimes it's better to sacrifice it for the key items. So the third one is up that elevator. That's the only reasonable out... Wait, I can actually do something with this? Oh, this wasn't an elevator at all. It just combines the save room. Wonderful, now we can get here easily. And we can transfer stuff instead of getting rid of it. Still not sure about the Magnum ammo. Could we have missed it on the way here? I really hope not. We did get a pistol, but the pistol seemed very weak, so I didn't equip it. It was basically an older version of this pistol that shoots faster. And I don't care about shooting faster, I care about just an efficient way of taking out zombies when I don't have anything else. And this is efficient, because it's you can aim easily, it's one shot, one shot, one shot. With the one that shoots fast, it's less accurate. And I don't think it does as much. I don't think it's as effective, so it's not worth it as a weapon to rely on when I have to. Okay, cool, now we can get to there easily too. Since it combines them. Is this actually a staircase we'll have to go on? Maybe it is. Or maybe I'm just confused. Well, obviously I'm confused. I've been confused since my conception. But I'm sure for that one thing is true. That this is the correct way to go for now. High grade. Cool, we don't have room for that. I wish it was a better weapon. Actually, no, I'm fine with it being the way it is. I don't need to use it. I have good old shotgun, if we'll find ammo for it anytime soon. I really hope we will, because it's a pretty fun weapon to use. That's a reassuring noise. That's a very large box, so it's not a normal zombie dog. Let's get out the grenade launcher so that we can be prepared to... Okay, good. There's only a couple of you guys in here. I'm scared about the other box, because this box is really small. Do we have a grenade? That's a lot. We have 6 of these. Let's use this weapon instead. I don't want to waste these grenades, because they might come in useful for this thing. Oh, it's just one of you. But you're stronger than the other ones. Come on, you had ammunition. Look what you're doing, Jill. Jill, you're not want to be eaten. Jill. Okay, this time, shoot the grenade. Reload that sucker, because you know what's about to happen next. Grab the fuse. Replace it with anything. get in here, because there's probably some loot in here, because that makes sense for loot just to be in this room with the zombies. I don't know who decided to put this in here, but it is, so deal with it. Okay, we can't pick up that loot. So just get the grenade launcher ready and be prepared to fire like 5 shots, because this thing is gonna take a while. Come on, you have tons and tons. There's no way this guy is gonna, okay, yeah. See how easy it was, Jill? If you just listen to the input controls, we'll be good. You'll be the biggest badass in Resident Evil history. I guess we have to go back now to the real nemesis of the game. The dude, he has some kind of accent. I think it's Russian. I'm not entirely sure, but I'm pretty sure it's Russian. Over there. Okay, I don't see him anymore. It's weird. We have to go back to that fuse box, though. Did you hear that? Where are you? He's gone. That freaking jerk. He's just a little sissy. Oh, great. This is fun. He just runs away when he finds that I have what I need to destroy him and all of his devious plans. That's a lot. Oh, they're protecting themselves. We need a bigger gun if they're gonna protect themselves. Come on. Oh, it took out all of them in one. Go, no it didn't. Get them before they cover their faces again. I think that's just the last one. That's pretty cool. They have a mechanic where they actually cover their faces. Is that regenerator gonna come to life? That'd be cool if that was their special quirk where they don't ever die. They just keep on coming back, but it just takes them a while. But so far, most of the zombies have been doing that in this game, which makes it hard to understand when a zombie will come up behind you and when they're actually dead. Wait, where did he go? Is that a secret elevator I don't know about?
He got away. What was he
There's another
doing
item
here?
Box. Well, he was stopping you, it seemed like. An unfinished activity log. Infiltrated at 1300, at 1930, officers engaged a pack of zombies. At 1200 on the day after, the tests ran at the university. Oh, the dogs. Tests on the dogs. The dogs killed a whole bunch of people. 7 survived. A bioweapon was deployed that was unknown. It wasn't theirs. They got eyes on 2 stars, a male infected and a female. Bioweapon is pursuing the female. The bioweapon is Nemesis. So they're tracking Nemesis, who's on the hunt for the STARS members, but it says unknown. That's weird. Female member has made contact with the platoon. Bioweapons appearance are consistent with Project N, with his Nemesis investigating. Nemesis learned how to hold weapons. It's super angry at Jill now. I guess it imprinted. Metamorphosis. Nemesis went through a metamorphosis because of Jill, because she was too badass for him. Jill was exposed to the virus 17 years ago. Conversion has been slow, suggesting that she may be resistant. Vaccine recovered and administered to Jill by Carlos. Jill keeps on causing Nemesis to evolve and become stronger. So I'm their secret plan. They're making it become stronger by like, it's like a Doomsday from DC, but it gets stronger from losing instead of dying.
Joe.
Watch out, there's a guy on the loose. Keep your eyes open, Tyrell.
I'm going to negotiate. You'll call off the strike if.
Please tell me you're not a bitten.
Big ass if. We can deliver the vaccine to them before they launch.
How long do we have?
Hours.
A tout. I was gonna say that as a joke.
Let's not waste one more second.
This way.
50 minutes. Oh, you know about this secret passageway? Are you
a
part of them?
Up ahead.
Of course you are. You're part of Umbrella. You're just not the evil part of Umbrella. Well, I guess all Umbrella is evil. There's just a lot of. This looks like a laser room. Come back here. No, don't stop running. Please stop running. Don't. Come on. You're gonna die.
Sure, you don't need to stop.
Stop and do what? I got your back.
Okay, good. All right. Stay here.
Let's get this done.
This is probably laser room, so leave it to Jill. I've seen the movies. I've played the game that had the laser room in it. I know what's gonna happen next. Or I'm assuming. I think I know. Whoa, frick. Is that Nemesis? That's not Nemesis anymore.
Keep going. We're almost there.
How about you put him in that room? Or he's just gonna die. A laser room would be nice at a time like this. As long as Jill can get through it. That's a heavy duty door. Look at those wiring and hydraulics and whatnot on the left and right. If he gets through this, he's probably strong enough to get through anything. The Pursuer. Nemesis is like a mix between the SCP that screams, Shy Guy, and Doomsday from DC Comics. Oh, I need an eyeball for this? Or a hand? Which one do I need? Hopefully I can get it fast, because I'm sure he's gonna get to us fast too. Oh, a safe room. And a locker with... Okay, I don't need that. I wonder what would be in that otherwise. That's one nice gaming computer. Why do they have a gaming computer with water cooling? Custom water cooling down here. I guess since they're such good at... They're such high up, they get to do whatever they want with their work computers. Attention, Nest 2 employees. The objectives of this T-Virus research facility differ from those of Umbrella's main Nest facility. Here we focus on real-world cases which arise as new bioweapons are created and introduced, such as the need for the T-Virus vaccines, and new weaponry capable of suppressing bioweapons. So this facility under the hospital is all about preventing what might go wrong. So this is the good facility. Some aspects of our work here can be dangerous, so it is imperative that all employees adhere to workplace regulations without fail. In particular, unauthorized entry by unapproved visitors or the removal of work-related data or materials will be met with severe disciplinary measures. It is a great honor to be part of the finest research organization in the world. Keep this in mind and stick to the rules as we forge new and revolutionary technologies. Oh, we got a map of the place. Okay, this is the way we came in, the sterilization room. This way is locked, which leads to a lot. And the way that we can go doesn't seem to lead to anything we can see. But we'll discover whatever it is after admiring that water cool computer. Kind of looks like mine, but mine's much more beautiful. My computer is my everything. Huh? What was I saying? Huh? I don't remember. What are you saying? I wasn't saying anything. Who are you? You're dead. That's what you are. Or undead, I should say. Generic zombie number 4 again? They seem to use this generic zombie more than all of the rest. Or maybe that one's just easier to differentiate. Oh, that's a lot of computers. Stop. I like this one because it's generic, but it was like the original zombie from, I think, Resident Evil, either Resident Evil 1 or the Resident Evil 3. It was like the first zombie ever seen in one of those two games. The pay was generous. The benefits were good. Most importantly, they promised me I'd be contributing to the state-of-the-art research tech research. For a university teacher stuck working in nowhere, America, it was a golden opportunity, like winning the lottery. How do you go from being a teacher in America to being a scientist in Umbrella? So I went for it. I made the pitch to my family and we agreed to move here to Raccoon City. The worst choice I've ever made. Well, hindsight is 20/20 because this lab is a den of monsters who conduct cruel and barbaric experiments for the sole purpose of taking human life in the most sickening way possible. It's messed up. The world needs to know. But every time I work up enough courage to blow the whistle, I think of Penny and Casey. And I immediately chicken out, because you are a scientist who is a chicken. Umbrella owns this town. There was this guy they caught trying to smuggle out company secrets. They essentially fed him to one of the betas. fed him. I saw the whole thing. I got my wife and daughter into this. I just need to do my job. Do as I'm told for their sake. But let this be a testament that I do have a conscience and that I've learned my lesson. Well, I'm sure you've learned your lesson. Your head's split open. You didn't seem to fix anything, unless that's not you. I really hope that's not you and you actually learned how to be a better person and how to stop Umbrella. Maybe you're the reason how we got the vaccine in the first place, along with that other doctor. This doesn't seem like a normal hospital. This looks like this is where they make yummy zombies. The kind with super stretchy arms that are flavored with the taste of death and mutatable. I really don't even know what I'm saying anymore. I'm too sidetracked by what's going on. The game, they just threw this random laboratory at us. Under a hospital. Essay on vaccine synthesis. On the roles of antigens and adjuvants in vaccine synthesis, Dr. Nathaniel Bard. Hey, this is the doctor who made the vaccine. Chief researcher, Spencer Memorial Hospital. To most efficiently synthesize a vaccine, both an antigen and an adjuvant are required. The antigen produces an immune response, while the adjuvant increases the effects of such responses, leading to an increased antibody production. By combining samples of these two ingredients, one can make a vaccine base. By processing this vaccine base with our proprietary equipment, a larger batch of vaccines, I don't understand what's going on here, can be created with astonishing ease. What's more, my latest antigen and adjuvant samples yield unprecedented rates of antibody production, producing more than 1,000 times the yield of traditional materials. This not only makes it an effective vaccine, but also a potential way to eliminate existing, infections. I don't understand.
Place the materials in the chamber.
Now I understand. We need to remake the vaccine.
I have to make it myself? Alright, gotta figure this out.
It's only two pieces, he said. I understand that much. But he seemed to be boasting his boat a little bit with his own intelligence.
What if we hear?
Or maybe he was just using scientific speech that I don't know because I'm not a scientist. Or someone who works in this fictional world. So we grabbed a flash chip. That's not a material though, unless it is. That means we need one more material. That's the material we need. It's in a glowing container in the middle of the room. That's clearly it. This flash drive, it unlocks the door to that room that we saw earlier. We just couldn't get to it. So I guess we just go back there. Unless we get stopped on the way, which is more than likely to happen. Nemesis, have you broken through that door yet? Or are you too weak? Maybe I shouldn't call you weak, because the last time Jill called you weak, you came out of the water as something 5 times larger than what you were before. It's not very difficult. If someone wanted to override, they could just not miss their shots and it would be better. They could walk up to that room up there that was unlocked. What was that noise? Sounded like a strange zombie mode that I'm not used to seeing. That's because there's two of them on the floor right there. Come on, shoot. Boom. Boom. You're already almost dead anyway, but I wasted that because I don't care. Why is your head glitching through the floor? Stop glitching through the floor. How am I expected to shoot you if you're glitching through? There's two of you. Okay, I guess that's why we got so many of these. Oh, you're screaming. You're screaming in agony and pain. Well, maybe you shouldn't have been such an abomination. Maybe you should have been a nice zombie. Not like Nemesis, but one that could almost talk. Kind of like Brad. Brad started talking for a little while before he decided to bite a piece out of that man's nards earlier in the game. I think that was like 2 episodes when we were playing as Carlos 2 episodes ago. Should we go up or down? We have to go up, because down probably leads to a more crazy experience, and up is an area we saw through the window, I think. Wait, we can't. What is that? Are those Nemesis babies? They look like metal egg sacs. And metal because Nemesis is so strong that he doesn't need normal egg sacky stuff. He needs super heavy duty egg sacky stuff. Stop. Stop. I think I missed. Okay, I guess you don't even exist because my shots went right through your head as if your character model wasn't even there. Some gunpowder that we can't really use unless we can combine it, which we can't. Oh wait, we can combine it with this though, which makes more shotgun shells, which is very nice because we can combine this with that. Now we have more room and now we have more gunshots. And we have a note, weaponry authorization request. Dear Dr. Emerson, I would like to formally request that the weaponry normally reserved for the bioweapon synthesis team be made available for any employees interfacing with the admission and dismissal of test subjects. These test subjects do not present the same levels of danger as our bioweapon products, but I believe that this weaponry authorization is advisable as outlined below. Recently, some test subjects have developed a new mutation, granting them very high regrowth abilities. They're called pale heads, not regenerators. Now I can call them what they're called, pale heads. They have been appearing with regularity, but the specific cause has not yet been determined. The astonishing rate at which these pale heads regenerate makes it difficult to deliver a lethal blow with a standard weapon. If any sort of system failure were to occur within our facility, we would be woefully unprepared to defend ourselves, I can see. For this reason, I would like to request that high-powered weaponry capable of subduing the pale heads be issued to all of our employees. I'm gonna get a really good weapon working in the shipping and processing. This is the Magnum. This will ensure that in the event of an emergency, we will be able to quickly eliminate them and evacuate safely. Clearly, they didn't work. They were not effective, or the people using them were not effective. Thank you very much for your consideration. Shipping and Processing Manager, Gabrielle Reed. I can't wait till I get a Magnum. Oh, here's one of the samples we need. So what's to the room to our left? Because I'm assuming downstairs is the second sample we need. We don't have anywhere to put it. We have to remove something. I love how they just have one that has yellow stuff in it, unless the yellow stuff comes out of the container.
I'll definitely need this for the vaccine.
Oh, the music's starting. Oh, something intense is gonna happen soon. I can feel it. Oh, I love it when the music starts kicking up near the end. It makes you feel a sense of accomplishment and dread. And you think that something really big and important is gonna happen, because that's what's gonna happen. Stop! You're dead. I know you regenerate, but you cannot regenerate after this. Okay, maybe you can. I'm gonna go find that Magnum so I don't have to deal with you this way. Wait, isn't there a downstairs somewhere? Where am I going right now? I think I'm lost. Yeah, this... Oh, the downstairs was this way. Come on. No. Yes? Good boy. I'm gonna have to treat you like one of those zombie dogs because you have the intelligence of one. You're super slow. I don't know how effective you are because you don't have giant teeth or anything. So I don't know how you could hurt me very badly. But you do regenerate very well. You better not attack me after I grab this dying message. It's happened. Our worst case scenario, the T-virus has somehow leaked. Under orders from Dr. Bart, I'm to manufacture mass quantities of the vaccine. I've prepared a culture of the T-virus antigen. Now I just need to combine it with an adjuvant to enhance its effects. I'm pretty sure that's what we got. And I should be able to produce enough vaccine to save the surviving citizens. The samples are stored in the incubation lab. Test subjects are already wandering the halls. But I'd better find a way to get some samples while the culture is maturing. If I don't make it back, please complete the synthesis process. Try to find a way to stop this outbreak. It's the least we can do. After setting these horrifying events in motion. So why is the Russian evil Nemesis man... I'm gonna call him New Nemesis, because Nemesis has become a giant monster. Why has New Nemesis stopped this process of curing everyone? He knows he's gonna get killed in the process of the nuke, so he wants to die, but that's not gonna solve anything. Even if he wants the zombies to take over the world, that's not gonna happen, because the nuke's gonna destroy the whole town. I guess he just wants the nuke to destroy everyone. Because he's a big baddie guy. He doesn't What's his motive, though? I want to know. We have a spray. We don't need to use it yet, so we'll probably end up dropping it when we find the vaccine. Why are we taking off the power? Or is this restoring power in some way, since it's unplugged? Oh, okay. I probably would have noticed if I did that first, but I wanted to explore that area before finding out what's over here, because this was clearly the path that leads to no return, or a return that's very nasty. Whoa. These are Mr. X. We haven't seen Mr. X yet. And oh, we're gonna find some Jesus. Mr. X's.
Is this where they're made?
That's so cool. I thought these guys were just like nature turning humans and the T-virus into tyrants. Something bigger. They are tyrants. That's so cool. Hopefully they don't all start running at me though, breaking through their glass. What is this? Is that one of the spider thingies? Or is that a head monster? I'm not sure. So are you telling me the T-virus doesn't create any of these? They create them. That's weird. That's interesting though. It's more realistic, I guess. But the T-virus mutates after they create these monsters. Because they've created these monsters and they've gotten much bigger and stronger, like we've seen with Nemesis. And tyrants don't look like that. They look a little bit bigger than that. So that means that they've gotten a little bit stronger. Those monsters though, over there, I think they're called Hunter Bravos or Alphas. They're exactly the same. Okay, not you. Stop shielding yourself. You shouldn't have shielded yourself. Now you're gonna get a grenade to the face. Oh, that's so cool. Now I'm gonna shoot them while they're down. Especially the ones that have shields on their heads. Because these guys just die pretty easily. I mean, they die super easily. What are you doing? Are you like pretending to be dead? Your tentacles are all moving around. So it's giving you away, buddy. We can create more shotgun shells or explosive shells. Too bad I got rid of all of them already. We still have the shotgun though, that reminds me. So we should probably start using this. Since we have it available, we shouldn't use it on the tiny monster like that. But since it's possible, we will. They look like Alien from AVP, or just Alien. The movie series. Expression of concern. Senior fellow Dr. Frankel, please allow me to introduce. What am I saying? To send my heartfelt congratulations to you and your colleagues at Umbrella Europe for completing Nemesis. So that's why he was on the helicopter plane sent here, because he was from another country. They have their facilities all over the map. That means after Resident Evil 7, it's probably going to take place out of the United States. Like Resident Evil 4. Oh, they're probably gonna reboot that game entirely. Instead of making like Lost Plagueis, they're gonna make it a facility of Umbrella there, or something like that, maybe. A truly remarkable achievement in the field of bioweapons research. Introducing a parasitic organism into a tyrant's brain through gaining external control of it. How can I not marvel at such a wild idea? It's a combination of the T-virus and a parasite. Is it? I think it's the Lost Plagueis? No, probably not. That's probably its own thing. Cool. Now we have both of them.
These are combined with antigens to increase immune system response.
Well, can't we just use our abilities to craft them together, since she seems to be pretty good at that? But no, we have to go all the way back to the machine to do that. That's fine though. It shouldn't be that easy. It couldn't be that easy. Because now that we've gotten both of them, and you could have made it either way. You could have chosen to go this way first, or you could have chosen to go the other way first. That was the area we saw that we need to get to now. I have a feeling on the way back, something's gonna stop us. The Russian guy, he's gonna destroy this sample. I have a feeling he has something to do with it. We haven't seen him though. So either he's been hiding! Stop! Oh my god. You are in a machine. You cannot come out like that. Why aren't the tyrants coming out like that? Why did this open by itself? Okay, what's this? I guess we don't have any explosive stuff. Are there gonna be more? There's no way, because we killed all of them on the way here. Unless the regenerators, the pale heads, I mean, come back to life. Here are the egg sacs. I guess they're tyrant egg sacs. And a tyrant plus a parasite creates a nemesis. What am I doing? How did I do that? How do I stop doing that? Go. That was strange. I guess there's a hidden key somewhere that allows you to look behind you, but I don't know how to do it again. Oh, I went the wrong way. Okay, we'll be right over there as soon as we get over there. Okay, here's the machine for them. Right here. So it should be simple. Just one.
Unauthorized materials detected.
Either I'm wrong or I'm missing a step.
What do you mean, unauthorized material?
Unauthorized materials detected.
Oh, maybe we do have to combine them. Okay, she could combine them. I guess this machine isn't just combining them, which makes sense. It's doing something to them. I don't know what. Oh no, don't tell me I have to do this. You should not expect me to know how to do this. Oh, we have to make them all even somehow. I don't know what this means. That looks pretty even to me. How do we make it go one more though? I don't think we can. What am I doing wrong? Well, I just realized this is temperature. And we're probably meant to keep it cooler. Something, I'm not sure. Oh, we're supposed to even them out. In the blue or green, maybe. Oh, cool, and the green works. Or maybe the blue is too cold and the red was too hot. So the green is right in the middle. That vaccine looks different from this. Okay, never mind. It's exactly the same. I was like, that stuff is blue. I'm pretty sure the stuff we used was this kind of purple. What if this wasn't really the vaccine and it was really something way worse? Jill, in the vents! I don't know how he fit in the vents, but his tongue is a very slippery foe. Come on, just cut it off. Stop poking, you're gonna stab your neck and you're gonna bleed out. Okay, if he's in the vents, unless his tongue is a mile long, that means he's not where we came from. And we need to get over there. Wait, what? Oh, we're going in the vents now. I see, Jill. You wanna beat him at his own game. That was a weird shot. Don't do that again, please. Please stop. I don't wanna look at a butt. It smells gross. It smells like sewage. Because you were in a sewer, smells like sweat, because this guy has been attacking you all day long and won't leave you alone. Wait, you're in here. Cool, the blast was just small enough to get him and not you. But if he survived what he survived. Oh, W, I don't like the pushing W, stop making me push W. Make me click the mouse instead. Is this a heartbeat thing? Or am I just jamming the button down? Oh, I'm supposed to hold the button down. Okay, I would have died because I was just going jam, 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 jam. Where are we running to? That vent? This is gonna take a while, Jill. Or is Carlos? Where has Carlos been all of this time? Or are we supposed to go with a certain pattern? I don't know. Each time I let go, we get back a foot. Okay, Carlos, I'm gonna rely on this explosion to save me. I really hope Carlos isn't down here still. The other man said he went down here. But we haven't seen Carlos. So unless he's dead, something's fishy. I don't think we need these anymore, so I guess we should just get rid of them. And this knife has not been effective throughout any of the game whatsoever. It shouldn't be like an inventory space. It should be like you pulled space and... No, I like this thing better. Maybe like you double click space? Yeah, you double click space to do this thing, and you hold space to use your knife. That would have been a cool mechanic, I think. Because the knife is just so weak, it's not worth inventory space, in my opinion. Okay, that feels like it was the final typewriter. I don't know what gives it away. Maybe the fact that Nemesis. I want to go back. Please. So we've explored this facility underneath the hospital. Underneath the hospital. Underneath the hospital. Thank you for watching, and we'll meet again. Probably today, because I'm going to finish this soon. I just don't like doing, because this is a minute over an hour now, and I don't want to have to make you sit through this. I want to make it short and sweet instead of just playing it all the way through once. And it also gives me a chance to make more thumbnails and to think about what just happened. So I'm not just blasting through a game in like 2 hours per session, because I feel like whenever people do that, they're not playing for fun, they're just playing to beat the game, basically, and I don't like that concept. So again, thank you for watching, and we'll meet again in the next contingency.